Why do we have 5 digits on our hands and feet? Why not 6 or 4? According to Scientific American, many millions of years ago, some tetrapods, meaning 4-limbed creatures, had more digits. But as animals developed better wrist and ankle joints, the number of digits was reduced over a very long period of time. Few animals have 6 digits, with the panda bear being a 4-legged beast that stands out from the crowd. Humans and animals may be born with an extra digit or 2, but this is the result of supernumerary digits appearing as a result of a physical anomaly known as polydactylism. Some people are born with fewer digits, and that's known as oligodactyly. Today, we'll look at the strange case of our diverse digits in this episode of the Infographics Show. Why are our fingers different lengths? We'll get to the length very soon, but first, let's talk a bit more about why we have 5 digits. We know that in the Devonian, there were many fish-like tetrapods with different digital ray numbers, say 5, 7, I believe up to 13. But by the end of the period, we had only pentadactyl tetrapods, said a paleontologist at Monash University. Pentadactyl means having 5 digits, but he then went on to say no one is exactly sure why 5 became the magic number. Science just tells us that's the way we've evolved. 4 would have been too few, and 6 too many. What makes humans the great manipulators of things we grab hold of are our excellent thumbs, which gives us more digit dexterity than our closest ancestors, the apes. We have something called flexor pollicis muscles, which gives us more control over our thumbs. In other primates, this muscle is either absent or works in a very rudimentary way. Apes can peel bananas, but we can carefully construct the internal organs of a highly complex watch. If you ever find yourself in the position of being told you have to lose a finger, you might think you should probably opt to lose your little finger or pinky finger to those of you in the USA. You certainly don't want to lose your thumb, sometimes called half of the hand, or the index finger, as those 2 digits work to do most of the work. Saying that, just losing 1 finger will profoundly affect the strength of your grip. Lose a thumb and life will get much harder. Imagine trying to button up a shirt, turn a key, play PlayStation, write with a pen, or even cut into a delicious steak without your thumbs. Okay, let's just imagine you've been kidnapped. And in a moment of altruism, your kidnappers tell you that you can choose which digit you will lose first. They also tell you that if they don't receive the ransom, then they're going to send more of your digits. A doctor interviewed by Business Insider says that people would often make the wrong choice and go Yakuza style and choose the pinky finger first. Apparently, that's the wrong choice. She said that your most expendable digit is the first finger of the hand you don't write with. She said if you lose that, your second finger will compensate for the loss quite well, while losing the pinky will affect the strength of your grip. That outlier pinky can't be compensated for so well. Business Insider wrote, "The pinky is actually incredibly important and it's a keeper. Basically, the reason humans have opposable thumbs, the springboard of our evolution from being just another ape, is that the thing doing the most opposing is the little finger." The New York Times wrote a story about this too called "The Importance of the Pinky Experienced Firsthand." This little digit provides a lot of strength. Try doing pull-ups and not using it and you'll see. As for toes, if the kidnappers have taken all your fingers, we're told that the most expendable digit is the 4th toe on the foot that you don't use for kicking things. By the way, if you want to keep all your fingers, there are some activities you should be mindful of. The US Consumer Product Safety Commission tells us the activities that cost people fingers are wood chopping, feeding paper shredders, chopping vegetables, working with industrial machines and power tools, cleaning stuff out of your lawnmower, and, a biggie for young people, closing windows and doors. Ouch. Okay, so now let's turn to the question asked in the show. Why are these digits all different lengths? Well, not all fingers are made equal. Some people do tend to have rather large hands and long fingers. It's quite complicated as to why some of us have bigger hands and longer fingers. It's generally thought that the ratio of your fingers is related to how much testosterone fetuses are exposed to in their womb. There are some pretty crazy studies out there. One such study wrote, "The ratio of the length of the second finger or digit to the 4th finger, 2D, 4D, is influenced by fetal exposure to androgens. A smaller ratio indicates greater androgen exposure." Believe it or not, that study said that men with longer ring fingers than index finger or first fingers were more agreeable with women, and men with longer index fingers were more likely to fight with females. This isn't pseudoscience, by the way. These were serious studies led by scientists. Other research shows that a long ring finger may lead to more risk-taking and better athleticism. One study at Oxford University even said that if the ring finger is longer, it may well lead to the person being more promiscuous. That's both men and women, so maybe you should check out your partner's hands today. If you're a promiscuous person, you can always blame the testosterone. It wasn't my fault. My exposure to hormones while in my mother made me do it. Case closed. You might also just have big hands and feet. You could be big in general, and so that's normal. But you might also have excessively large hands for your size. That could just be hereditary. Does the size of your hands correlate with penile size? That's the million-dollar question. Live Science tells us that various studies have come up with different conclusions. Once again, some studies tell us that more testosterone in the womb, larger ring finger, bigger phallus. But it's not conclusive. And don't go judging a book by its cover. So you might have small hands for a big man, you might have finger ratio differences, but why are your fingers not all the same length? Unlike other primates, as you know, we have this marvelously strong thumb. We also have shorter digits and a smaller palm. Gizmodo talks about the perfect opposability of our thumb, meaning it can touch the tips of each of our fingers with finesse, or it can lock on tight. This gives us the ability to firmly manipulate objects and also tinker with things. This is why we're the great tool makers of the animal world. Well, that and our excellent brains. Millions of years ago, our ancestors had the hands we see of modern primates. Long and strong fingers that were good for tree climbing, but not so good for threading a piece of cotton through the eye of a needle. Some scientists tell us that our hands evolved in line with the tools we were making. 3.4 million years ago, when we started making crude stone tools, we didn't need so much dexterity. But later, we refined our tools when we had better dexterity. We only have that dexterity because our fingers are perfectly sized to oppose our thumb. It wouldn't make much sense to have a longer pinky finger, for instance. But it wasn't just about making tools. It was what we did with those tools. We fought each other and we hunted. To do that well, we needed to have a very strong grip. If you're going to club your enemy to death, you'll need to be able to grab a hold of that weapon with a strong grip. But we also have a precision grip, which is different. When the person didn't have a club lying next to him, he might have picked up a stone. The way we hold stones or balls or darts is very different from the grip we employ when holding an axe. Scientists tell us that this is precision grip that really led to the evolution of our different sized fingers and how they work so well with our thumb. Next time you're up close to a chimpanzee, hand it a stick and see how well it can manipulate it without dropping it. Better still, hand it a tennis ball and watch how much difficulty the chimp has keeping hold of it. We're kidding, don't go near chimps, they might pull your fingers right off. Okay, so we evolved with these hands to make complex tools and also to have strong grips that are firm and precise. So why not just evolve to have even longer fingers and have more precision? The Economist touches on this question and it seems the answer might be boxing. Can you imagine Mike Tyson with long witch fingers? It wouldn't work. Long fingers, as we have seen, are good for climbing, but they're not good for making a fist. In fact, we don't see monkeys getting into punch-ups, although that would be quite amusing. A paper in the Journal of Experimental Biology by Michael Morgan and David Carrier of the University of Utah tells us that our hands are the way they are not just because of grip or precision or watchmaking, but also because when we scrunch our fingers into a fist, we have a weapon already. The scientists conducted an experiment with athletes, including boxers, in which they were asked to hit a punching bag as hard as they could, both with an open palm and with a fist. They then asked the athletes to form badly made fists, such as with a pointed thumb or the fingers laying flat on the palm and not dug right into it. You won't be surprised to hear that the properly made fist delivers much more power than any other way you could hit a punching bag. We now have to acknowledge that it's only because we have varying finger lengths that we can make this ideal fist. This with the thumb creates the perfect storm of a stiff fist. If a monkey tried to do it, there would be a space between the fingers and the palm, so its fist would not be anywhere near as powerful. Before we started making tools or throwing stones, we were heavy punchers, primitive pugilists who didn't have a spear to fall back on when the going got tough. Can you add anything to the story of our hands and fingers? Tell us in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video, What Would Happen If You Only Drank Coke? Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.